If you want to learn more about human evolution, ancient inventions, ancient structures, new archaeological discoveries, then don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Hit that notification bell, click that like button, and leave me a comment down below. Did a supervolcano kill the Neanderthals? As we all know, there is a lot of speculation about the sudden disappearance and demise of the Neanderthals, and subsequently Denisovans. There are many theories and plausible hypotheses, but could an erupting supervolcano be the actual culprit? Or was it merely the straw that broke the camel's back? Let's find out, shall we? My name is Kaylee, and in today's video, we are going to take a look into the plausibility of the Great Campanian Ignimbrite eruption being the reason behind the extinction of Neanderthals. Campi Flegrei is a supervolcano to the west of Naples in Italy, close by Mount Vesuvius, as you can see here. We all know that the eruption of Mount Vesuvius was devastating to the immediate surrounding towns and people in quite a radius. But if we're going to be completely honest and frank, the eruption of Mount Vesuvius was child's play when compared to the eruption of supervolcano Campi Flegrei approximately 37,000 years ago. The eruption of Campi Flegrei is also known as the Great Campanian Ignimbrite eruption, and this was the largest and worst eruption in Europe in the past 200,000 years. If you've seen my Doggerland video that I made in August of 2020, you probably remember me mentioning the Lager Zee volcanic eruption that occurred some 13,000 years ago, which at least had a negative impact on the climate and is, in my personal opinion, at least complicit in the onset of the Younger Dryas. In that video, I mentioned the destruction that the Lager Zee volcano unleashed, with no tree standing upright within 4 kilometers of the volcano, a plume reaching 40 kilometers high, and the falling ash from the volcanic eruption reached a radius of 300,000 square kilometers, which is a very large area from northern Italy to Sweden, from Poland to France. That's nearly the entirety of Europe that got covered in ash. The Lager Zee volcanic eruption has been classified as a 6 on the volcanic explosivity index. So knowing that, knowing the absolute devastation that occurred approximately 13,000 years ago and the effects it had on the climate, I can tell you with absolute certainty that the eruption of Campi Flegrei was worse. Way worse, to be completely honest. Campi Flegrei erupted, and the radius of spewed ash has been estimated to have been 3.7 million square kilometers. Let that sink in for a moment. The Lager Zee volcanic eruption spewed ash in a radius of 300,000 square kilometers, while Campi Flegrei volcano spewed ash in a radius of 3.7 million square kilometers. That is absolutely insane. So that's not just the entirety of Europe, but like Russia, Asia, Northern America, even partially, it's bad. So not only was the falling back down to earth ash from this volcano a massive issue, I think the poisonous sulfur dioxide it released into the atmosphere was way worse than the ash. It released 450 million kilograms of sulfur dioxide into the atmosphere, subsequently cooling the entire northern hemisphere by temperatures of 1 or 2 degrees Celsius for at least 2 or 3 years. But in Europe, the temperatures might have dropped by as much as 3 degrees Celsius. And in Russia, where the ash cloud mostly spread, temperatures might have dropped as much as 6 degrees Celsius. That is absolutely insanity. That is global catastrophe level. So now you may think 1 or 2 degrees Celsius on average, that isn't too bad, but this is quite the massive temperature change on a global scale, which would have severely impacted all living creatures in Europe and would have had an impact in some way on all life on Earth, to be completely honest. It's not just, you know, some ash. We've recently seen the devastation of a volcanic eruption and the shockwave that happened with the volcano that erupted on the island of Tonga, or in the ocean near the island of Tonga, which is estimated to have been either a 5 or a 6 on the volcanic explosivity index. They're currently still calculating the exact placement, but it won't be higher than a 6, and I don't think it will go lower than a 5 from my research. The shockwave from the Tonga eruption was felt in the Netherlands, to give an example. That's like the other side of the world. So it's hard to fathom just how destructive the eruption of Campi Flegrei would have been for the people living in Europe around that time, but even for the people living in North America or like Australia or wherever in the world. I think the shockwave would have been felt everywhere. So let's take a look at the inhabitants of Europe and Russia, because the effect was felt far and wide and mostly by the inhabitants of these regions. We know that Neanderthals lived in smaller communities, and we also know that there were fewer Neanderthals and Denisovans roaming around approximately 40,000 years ago when compared to modern humans, or Homo sapiens, whatever you want to call it. Everyone prefers another name, whatever. It is believed that Homo sapiens reproduced faster or with more ease, and therefore had strength in numbers, although this hypothesis will be looked into in a separate video in the future, so yeah, I'm not going to go into that right now, because we have so much to uncover about these archaic humans and their intricacies, and new discoveries keep being made, so I'm afraid that I'll never really stop making these sort of videos. I don't think the human tree of life will ever be completely done on my channel, because we keep uncovering more. But that's besides the point of today's video, so back on track to the subject of the day. You know, it's probably best to stick to my script. Oops. We know that Neanderthals disappeared somewhere between 40,000 and 35,000 years ago, and this does fall in the same time frame as the eruption of Campi Flegrei. It is believed that the Denisovans disappeared around this time as well. Same time as the Neanderthals, they disappeared sort of together, it seems. Like, we don't find any fossils of either after 35,000 years ago. So we know that most Neanderthals lived in Western Europe, and that the Denisovans lived mostly in modern-day Russia and Asia. Around 40,000 years ago, the number of Neanderthals and Denisovans were already declining, with Homo sapiens spreading more and more into their territories, slowly taking over their living environment. Researchers don't believe that the Neanderthal and Denisovan communities lived close enough by the volcano to be directly impacted, although there is a possibility that the existence of such communities close by have been completely wiped from the face of the earth, leaving absolutely no trace. It is very possible that we just can't find any evidence of that because, I mean, the shockwave and everything, it just blew them away. The ash cloud and most of the poisonous sulfur dioxide spread east, away from the Western European Neanderthal territories. But to be completely honest, this was, as you can imagine, straight towards the Denisovan territories in Russia and Asia, as you can see on the screen here. The ash and the sulfur dioxide would have resulted in acid rains as well, across parts of Europe, Asia, and even as far as North America. So even if these archaic human communities didn't witness the actual eruption itself, they would have, without a doubt, felt its effects in terms of like a shockwave and acid rains, and it would have severely impacted their lives, with sunsets that would have been dark and red for about a year after the eruption due to the high concentrations of sulfur in the atmosphere. The eruption took place in an especially cold and dry period in the last ice age, and would have without a doubt made conditions much worse for the Neanderthals, the Denisovans, and modern human populations. The ash that rained back down on Earth would have been incorporated into plants, which would then be eaten by various animals and the surviving hominids, and the surviving hominids would have eaten the animals. This could have potentially resulted into a condition known as fluorosis that can lead to tooth, eye, and organ damage. So if we add everything that I've just spoken about up, we can very easily deduct that at the very least, the eruption of Campi Flegrei had a negative severe negative impact, I should say, on both Neanderthals, Denisovans, and Homo sapiens. And of course, all the other living beings and creatures on the planet. The initial eruption would have been a terrible devastation. The ash clouds and poisonous sulfur dioxide would have caused acid rains that would have been crippling to these ancient communities. And the subsequent cooling down of the average temperature globally by at least 1 or 2 degrees Celsius would have made survival even harder. And for the ones that did manage to survive all of this destruction around them, they might have died due to complications of the condition known as fluorosis, which could have damaged their organs and be the final nail in the coffin for both Neanderthals and Denisovans. The worst impact of the eruption was felt in modern-day Russia, where the average temperatures may have dropped as much as 6 degrees Celsius. And this was the region where the Denisovans inhabited the lands. And this could very well have been the reason as to why they disappeared. So maybe the Neanderthals survived the initial years after the volcanic eruption. I do feel like the Denisovans were hit the hardest. So while we don't have conclusive evidence pointing to the eruption of Campi Flegrei being the actual complete culprit of the Neanderthal extinction, it definitely, without a doubt, had a negative impact on the already dwindling numbers of them around the time of the eruption, and it could have been the straw that broke the camel's back. Now, you might think that in modern times an eruption like Campi Flegrei is unlikely to take place, but unfortunately I am here to ruin your positive thinking. In 2016, it was discovered that the Flegreian fields, better known as Campi Flegrei, was stirring once again. Which is fun. And it's not that strange that the Romans and the medieval Christians called Campi Flegrei the gateway to hell, because it's geologically speaking still an active volcano. The magma under the caldera is releasing water-rich gases that could cause the rock surface above it to collapse, which would lead to another eruption, which isn't fun. And of course, we can't be sure how devastating an eruption might be in modern times. The Campi Flegrei volcano erupted twice after this devastating eruption 37,000 years ago, with both of these later eruptions being a lot less severe. So let's hope that there won't be a terrible eruption of a supervolcano anywhere in the world, because that would be bad, very bad, which is probably the understatement of the century, I bet. Volcanic eruption is bad. Supervolcanic eruption is bad. So to summarize, the eruption of Campi Flegrei most likely is not the direct cause for the extinction of Neanderthals and possibly even the Denisovans, but it could have been the last nail in the coffin for these archaic communities. I will of course look into more theories surrounding the extinction of Neanderthals and Denisovans, as this is just one of many theories or hypotheses or however you want to call it. So yeah. What do you think caused the demise of the Neanderthals and Denisovans? What do you think is the reason that they went extinct? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, not just in the chat if you're watching the premiere, but in the comments down below so that I can get back to you and we can go back and forth. Also check out the description for my sources that I used to write the script and more information if you like to read more about, for instance, the Campi Flegrei volcano or the Great Campanian Ignimbrite, or the Great Campanian Ignimbrite eruption. I mean, I can talk. Not always, but there are moments that I can talk. But yeah, if you enjoyed watching this video, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos. And click that bell icon if you want to be notified every time I upload. I do the occasional live stream out of the blue. Or like now, just upload without saying anything, because I like that. If you haven't seen my previous videos yet, then click the card in the upper right corner or click one of the links in the description down below, above the sources or below the sources, whatever. It's there in the description. Just check it out. Click one of the videos in the end card if you have no idea what you want to watch. I've also put like the card, so enjoy. Go wild. I would also like to say a massive, massive thank you to everyone supporting me and the channel and my work, my channel members and my patrons. I'm eternally grateful for your support and I hope that I can keep making you proud. I'll do my best. And I won't call you filthy hobbitses in the future, probably, but it was fun in the last video to say filthy hobbitses a couple times. I mean, I'm a child. Let's be honest. I'll never completely grow up. Goddamn. I always blab on the end. I enjoyed making this video. I like looking into the possibilities of extinctions and why extinctions happened. And there will be a video about a certain mass extinction very soon on the channel. It has to do with my sister and I will not give any hints besides that. But when that video hits, I hope that everyone will be here to watch it because I interviewed my own sister back in October. We've been planning to make this video, but it's been a long waiting game. But we're nearly there. We're in the final stretches. So yeah, this was me and Campi Flegrei supervolcanic eruption that could or might or possibly have attributed to the extinction of the Neanderthals. Yeah, that's a thing. Also, for the people thinking that I drink alcohol in every video, I really don't. This is just how I am. I usually drink cola or energy drinks or sparkly water with a peachy flavor because, I drink alcohol maybe once or twice a week. I don't drink much. People think I always drink. I really don't. I mean, I like to keep the body healthy. I exercise a lot and, you know, take good care of myself. I plan to live to be like 100. If it's up to me, I will. Just don't have a truck crash into my body and kill me, and I'll be fine, I think. Yeah, thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one. And this was fun. Extinctions, they're not fun. Why did I say that this was fun? I'm such a bitch.